Welcome to Professor's Garage. We have only had this car for a few days, and there's already a major problem with ABS.
Look, spongy brake.
I went to fix a minor ABS issue, and this is what I got. See how many lights and warnings? Totally insane. Okay, let's take a look. Health report. So it's all this code, all ABS related. Long list of issues because of one component. When south, it triggers all the problems. So hopefully I will be able to find out how to fix it tonight. So wish me luck.
For your information, this is a pre-purchase issue that the seller agreed to cover, but they hire a mechanic who did everything wrong.
The ABS unit is not compatible with the vehicle. I will show the part numbers of this one compared to the original one. They are different. Fortunately, I still have the original ABS, so I'm going to swap this out and put in the original one. So hopefully I will be able to restore this back to normal. This is the original ABS module. And just by looking at it, we can see how many brake lines are connected to it in and out. So these are the ones that we'll have to remove from the module there, and then we'll be able to put this in. Also, when you do ABS bleeding, very important to keep a big bottle of brake fluid. For this vehicle is stock 4, but first we need to remove the electrical connectors.
Then there's a latch here. You should pull it up, and then you should be able to remove it. Yep. And then it's loose. You can remove the connector here. And this is the first thing. Now, disconnect it from the system. We can take care of the brake lines. This is in size 11. Let's see if we can remove it. And break through it will come out. It will remove it. So it's best to have some power in here before it's leaking through it. Take out another one. 4 output lines going out to the 4 wheels. This. And then hopefully you can see there are 2 in the back here, the same size. And then one more. So these are small, very small size brake lines, and just like your bleeder, it only requires a very small torque to tighten them. So I don't think it takes lots of force to remove them. So you should be able to easily remove them. So now I'm going to tackle the input lines, and these should be these are 12 size 12. So let's loosen them counterclockwise. Okay. The same on the other side. This one is a bit tricky because of the space, but I think with some patience we should be able to do it. Hopefully the bleeding will be smooth. And then because I'm putting the original equipment back, so what I hope is that the system will not give me too much trouble, because I think it will recognize the old friend is back. And they will just recognize each other, and it's a happy world. So right now, I think they are loosened and can be removed. There's actually not too much brake fluid coming out, so which is good news. Also, when you work with brake fluid, be careful not to get them to the body of your car. Be super careful. There's a 10 millimeter here. I should have removed it first, the mount for the unit. 10mm bolt. Now you can pull the, just put the brake lines out of the way. And then there are actually three mounting points. One is tightened by a bolt. You remove the bolt.
The other two are simply rubber grommets that you push into place.
And you can just pull it up. And then you should be able to remove it. Just be careful with the brake lines. Don't kink them. I think, and also pay attention to the flares of the brake lines, because you don't want to ruin them. So for now, I'm going to wrap this in the tower. Just make sure I don't drop any brake fluid onto the car. I just want to make sure the brake lines are okay, and then I don't damage any connectors. Clean it as much as I can.
The two units, this is the original unit, and this one is the one that they purchased to replace it, which doesn't work. Their sizes are very similar, but if you pay attention to the part number, I will highlight here, but the last few digits are different. I know this one is original. This one is from another vehicle, which this BMW here doesn't recognize.
Now I'm ready to put this back on. This is the original part from the same vehicle here. And before I put it back, you can examine the ports, especially make sure they are clean. Pay attention to the brake lines. My finger is touching it on the second mounting point. I feel it, so it should be in place. Now I can push it all the way in and then make sure I don't crush anything, and that should be good. Okay, so looks like everything is in place indeed.
Yeah, you can also feel it.
I think it should be in place.
So what I'm going to do now is to put the brake lines back on and hope not to damage anything.
So gently put things in place before you set them on. Okay, very good. I think this one is making things easier. Okay.
So I'm going to first use my fingers to start them on. This is back on. And hopefully there's no learning engaged. I do have scanners that is capable of reprogramming ABS and things like that, but when it comes to BMW, there's always uncertainty. We share this journey. Enjoy it.
This tool, I purchased it a while back for this application. Not bad. It's like a ratchet. I don't have all the sizes, but this size 12, it fits, which is good. In this tight space, no perfect solution, but you will only work with whatever tool that you have, right?
This ABS unit is already very expensive. Labor, even more. So if you can do it yourself, you can save lots of money, and perhaps your family will allow you to add some tools to your toolbox, right? A good deal.
It's really tight even to turn with the wrench. It may already reach the end, or maybe it's cross-threaded, so I think be super careful with it. And let's double check the other ones. Yeah, of course you want to press it, right? And then turn it.
So I will let you take a closer look on the unit. What I was talking about earlier was like this one here, the threading, it goes in more. Very few threads left. But this one, it stops here. Still lots of threads. That is the way it is. Double check that everything is tightened. Okay, and that should be it. Now, before you forget, put this mounting bolt back on.
Pin tight. It's not going anywhere. again, right off and break through it. Now that everything is ready, we can put the connector back. In the way they are engaged, put them in and then press it down. It clicks. Great. Again, make sure all the brake lines are tightened, not super tight. Moment of truth.
I'm going to start the car. Double check.
No leak, which is great.
Master cylinder reservoir. Make sure it's topped off. Again, on the cap, dock 4. So that is a brake fluid you should use. So I'm going to go to ABS bleeding. Good thing it has BMW. Okay, so let's read the instructions together. Okay, continue. There is a recommended sequence of doing the bleeding. Rear left, front left, and then front right, rear right.
Jack up the car and put it on the jack stands. Remove the wheels and follow the procedure to bleed the caliper on each wheel.
Bleeder here.
This is my setup. My adapter fits. Put some fluid already in there. And we're going to start the bleeding procedure. Now I open the bleeder on the rear left. Let's continue. Hear the sound. Yeah, there's a fluid coming out of it. It looks quite dirty. Okay. So the first cycle was done. Before we move on, let's close the bleeder.
Check fluid.
Lots of air.
Continue to bleed
until it's clean and free of air bubbles.
Close the bleeder and done with this particular wheel. The last wheel, the bleeder is loose, almost running out of fluid, just a little bit.
The last wheel is bleeded, it looks good.
So now close it off, just enough to top it off. Wow.
Just a little bit, that will go a long way.
Final check, all dry. Pump the brake a few more times. I don't see any fluid coming out of it, so it should be all good. All done. Have a test drive with your most important tools for this job, just in case. All the code is clear.
I scanned the system, no more warning lights, and everything looks great. And most important, the brake is firm. It's all done for today, and there's more to come on how to maintain a BMW and make it reliable. I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. Consider giving it a like and subscribing to Professor's Garage. Stay tuned for more car care and repair contents. If a professor can do it, you can do it. Until next time, may the Lord bless you and grant you peace. 平安.